idea for this talk was given to me on Twitter. I didn't really know what Spletne was. And I asked to talk about JavaScript libraries because I was what we call a developer last year, very active. Now this year, not so much. Because I've started more using it, less improving because I have everything right I need right now. They may change later. This is my section speaking with Andrew last night or the night before, I don't remember. But I wanted to warn you that I'm obviously biased. And I'm not going to tell you to actually use it. This guy is going to tell you. I'm going to do a quick overview. Try to do it in under half an hour. Of what JavaScript libraries does, which is better. And how can you use this knowledge to like one for you and for your business. And yeah, I'm also going to some tricks in JavaScript development, not something that I've made up, something that you can read from blogs, the JavaScript blogs over the blogosphere, but for maybe those who haven't yet picked up practices tonight, they might learn something. Okay, so we posed this question of available libraries because there are a lot of them. Really, there are not a lot of them when we just talk about the popular ones. That's what the mainstream users use, so we can safely say that, I don't know, 80-90% of people just use 4 of them or 5 of them. And also, there's another question. How do we choose? For instance, how did I choose to use prototype? How did I end developing it, being core developer? How did so many people choose to use jQuery? Why? And hopefully I answered some of these questions during the talk. So, the most I know from JavaScript library, obviously, the JavaScript library that I've contributed to arranged submodels, forms, realization, objects, and events were written by me 1 year ago. And this is the library I'm going to have most examples of in my store. But lately, and lately it's 2 years ago, there was a serious contender. And right now, jQuery is the single most popular library by wide margin comparing to other libraries. So why is that? This framework just started the dollar function. Dollar function originally borrowed from prototype. I have done some research in the past days, and I believe I'm only settled to sure that Sam Stinson of prototype invented the dollar function. And said a dollar character is allowed to be a name, so why not make a function of it? And jQuery used the neat idea, and John Resig made a library that's based on CSS selectors and does everything mostly operating on collections of elements written about those CSS selectors. And that was a neat idea. People call it neat hack. In 2005 and all 2006, but in the end of 2006 and mostly in 2007, they realized that not just the neat hack, it has grown and it has become a full-fledged library. It has learned from all other libraries, and it has evolved to be single most popular and also very, very good because it's not popular just by school design of the homepage. It's popular by because of one thing that I'm going to mention. So the libraries you might heard of are Node Toolkit, which seems to go away of dinosaur equipment right now. It's losing its momentum and it's losing its community. Dojo Toolkit was almost dead last year, at the beginning of last year. Then they made a huge are back on their feet, they have pretty impressive modules for operating with things, but as it goes, for most basic things that you will need, I'm not saying basic for simple stuff, I'm saying basic for usual 90% of user scenarios you will use a JavaScript library. You will not probably tomorrow when you code JavaScript, you will probably not create an email, but or 208 slides, but you will use it on the blog, you will use it on the company web, you will use it to make a cool promo on the front page, and you will use it to make all sorts of good user interaction, but this library doesn't belong in the category of general libraries. It's more specific, tailored to the needs of very different modules that you can read about on their page. I haven't hacked on Dojo yet, so I can give you many more examples. One also contemporary in the rising era of prototype and theory was Moodles. And even I didn't check it out in the past few months. I have not only me, but other people from Prototype Library did beginning of 2008. And all we learned from looking at the code was code from other libraries. That's without attribution, that's copied or rewritten, but it's the same thing as found in other libraries, made into a framework of its own, and called the copycat framework, because it's rarely innovated, it just followed along with the theme of the frameworks, and now it has some pretty decent plugins, it has some pretty decent functionality to play with, but I failed to see any advantage over, for instance, jQuery, which is Moodle, probably just a subset of. And lastly, library without logo is Yahoo, is a user interface number. And I really don't have a logo. I didn't manage to find it in 1 hour of finding it, so I just do the Yahoo smiley face. You use a very interesting library. You used it in some project, doing some intranet user interface, and it's very impressive. Just downloading it, cloning it from the repository, you get more than 100 megabytes of stuff. And the least of that is code. There's tons of other things. Okay, there may be documentation, like in the package you download, there may be some other tools, but it's pretty huge. But of course, like all the Moodle libraries, you don't have to use it all. You pick the things you will use. It's a pretty special framework. It's even further away from prototype jQuery from mainstream libraries than Dojo took it. It doesn't provide almost any core extensions for basic stuff for numbers, strings. It just has some